All right, guys, we are live. How you doing? This is Caesar here, and I just want to check the audio. Looks like the audio looks good. Okay. So what I want to talk to you about today is Kodi, and as we have folks joining here, you guys are welcome to answer questions throughout the night. I'll be reminding folks here shortly about asking questions, and we're going to be talking about Kodi and how to install it on your computer. So. And this can also work for a tablet, an Android tablet. A little difficult on an Apple device, iPad, or any type of device like that. It's a little difficult to install on one of those because that has to be jailbroken. Okay. And then we'll talk about some options here of other options that you can do with Kodi. So let me check to make sure. Let me post a live feed here. The room. Okay. Perfect. I think that went through. Maybe not. Let's try that again. It took me a lot of changes. It's you have to go through a couple of tabs to do a post inside a page. So, what's up, C's?
Mom just asked me to
get my phone and. So I'm gonna share my screen here. Give me a second here while I share my screen, and you guys are welcome to take a look at that. So, let's go ahead and do that. Cameraman, let's see. Share screen. There it is. And I gotta find the right location. Thought there's a way to share the whole thing, but maybe not. Okay, so let's take a look at here. I'm not sure why it's not showing on my end of my screen, so I'm going to have to take this screen sharing off. They used to allow for, let's try this again. My wife should send me a text. Let me respond real quick. Okay. So, let me see some here. There's a comment tracker on the left-hand side or right-hand side for you. You can write comments there and questions. Test. And the tab at the right, yeah, you should be able to ask questions there as well. Q&A, showcase, and screen share, and chat. So I guess there's like a chat tab. There it is. Test. All right, just sent the test. So what I want to talk about is that what I like about you building your own box and Kodi is you have full control of a computer's resources. For the average person, that might not make any sense, but usually a computer has a lot more memory, a lot more space, so if you're going to be downloading a lot of content like movie posters and that kind of stuff for your local media, right behind this camera, I have a couple terabyte drives. I think a total of 6 terabytes. Each drive is 3 terabytes, and that contains my family photos, my music collection that I use for both my DJ business as well as my music for just personal use here, and also my movies. And the cool thing about Kodi is that it has the ability to have a tab for each section. Photos, you know, pictures, and music, and movies. And for the movie section, it allows you to download the cover art. So it would recognize, based off the name, it would recognize that information. And that's pretty cool. So you don't have to stream it in the internet. You can actually stream it locally. So that's kind of cool. So I'm gonna give it a few more minutes here. I want to make sure we got enough people on the Hangout before I continue. And I need to respond to my wife real quick, so let me do that. Jarvis just responded, so let me look at Jarvis real quick. Just be a moment here, guys, before I can continue. Just waiting for a few folks to join. Let me know if you can see me, Jarvis.
Says you're
going to see your card. Yeah. Thank you, buddy. Cool. Okay, can you see me, Jarvis? Or anybody else in the room? Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and continue here, guys. All right, so it looks like we got a viewer to join. Cool. Okay, guys, thanks for the patience. So going back, so Kodi itself is a software that was built on XBMC. The original name was Xbox Media Center, the very first Xbox, which I actually have in my office here. So there was actually a community of folks that designed it for this guy right here. Xbox. Some of you remember that. This is my custom Xbox. Pretty cool. It's got the Transformers. I kind of modified the look of this one for fun, but I used to get into these and modify them for fun. So I can add music, I can add movies and all kinds of goodies to it. So from there, it expanded. It became this Android box now world. Little Android boxes are coming out, very popular right now. And I'll be talking about one here towards the end of this presentation, about one that I may be aligning myself with. For a long time, I followed a lot of different boxes. I sold a few 100 boxes and then did really well. But then I just couldn't find the right group of leaders that were building the boxes. A lot of them were turned out to be really greedy pricks, to say the least, and it just didn't make sense. And so I wanted to make sure I aligned myself with the right person, and I think I may have just found that person, and I'll be sharing the information on that box later. But what I want to show you is I won't be able to show you the premium add-ons that these boxes have. So there's a few premium add-ons, are called add-ons, that plug into the box that allow you to watch live TV, as an example, that allow you to watch sports access. You know, some of this stuff called the sports access. Some of these other add-ons that are just not available on the traditional internet. You have to kind of seek them, and a lot of these guys have relationships with the add-ons. So this guy. Particular guy has premium add-ons, and so that's what makes those boxes a little bit better. And you just got to find that right box. Okay, so that's what makes it different. So a lot of times I'm asked, you know, what makes a box better than the Fire Stick, and so Fire Stick is no different than what I'm about to show you tonight. Except with Fire Stick, you have to be careful with some updates. You know, if the Amazon Fire Stick gets updated by a software or firmware pushed by Amazon, then you're SOL. You cannot do anything about it anymore. Your software has been overwritten, and you have to find a new hack for it, and it's a pain in the neck. And so I don't like to get those types of boxes. Apple TV was the same way. I couldn't update my Apple TV box because of the same scenario. You're kind of locked into the updates of the manufacturer, and so you want to make sure that manufacturer is not involved with pushing updates that would hinder your current setup. So with that said, there is an add-on system here that's called it's called Community Build. So if we all go to, and I'm going to punch this into the chat room here. If you guys should be able to see this chat here, if we all go to Kodi.tv, and let me do that now. I'm going to screen share my screen, and we'll go to let's go to screen two. All right. If we all go to Kodi.tv here, and I'm on a computer, a Windows computer. Some folks don't know the difference. A Windows computer has Microsoft Windows. It's owned by Microsoft Windows, or rather Microsoft, and a computer that is not Windows would be a Macintosh, and the Macintosh computers, you can do the same thing. You can go here, you can click on downloads, and then you can see here we have Windows. If you're a Linux person, you probably wouldn't be on this webinar if you're a Linux person, because you probably already know how to do this. Macintosh people are, you can go to Macintosh. If you have a Macintosh desktop, you can do it. And Android. If you have an Android, you can go to the Google Play Store, or you can download the APK, depending on the different versions here. X86 would be a computer hardware. An ARM would be like your phone, okay? So that's the difference between those two there. There is a stripped-down version of Linux called Ubuntu, which is just another variation. I guess this is a variation of that called Kodi Ubuntu. I want to guess it's built off the Ubuntu Linux box. You don't have to worry about that. I mentioned this earlier. If you're on an iOS, an Apple device that is an iPhone or an iPad, or any type of variation of that, it must be jailbroken, and it is not the easiest thing to do unless there's an available hack for it. So in my experience, I've had trouble with keeping this stable. I would open it up, and it would crash on me all the time. So it wasn't very, very cool on iOS, and this was back in when I had my current phone, which is an iPhone 6 hacked. So it wasn't like an old phone. It was actually pretty new, and it couldn't handle the stability. So I wouldn't recommend it. It's not worth it. Get yourself a cheap tablet, like an Android tablet, and you can do it there. Raspberry Pi is a small device that you can buy off the market for about 50, 60 bucks. Again, very low memory, not really worth the trouble of going through that. And then there's other variations here. So tonight we're gonna be talking about Windows. the Windows plugin, the Windows install for this. And I just want to let you know that this is pretty straightforward. You're going to click on this button here. It's going to download a program called Jarvis. And it's kind of interesting because I don't know too many folks named Jarvis, but we actually have a gentleman that is owns a box named Jarvis on the team. So maybe it was named after him because of his passion for the box. I don't know. So click on that. The latest build is 16.1 called Jarvis right there. It's going to download. It's about 83 megabytes. You can see it going away. And I got to open up my Facebook message real quick, and I'll put this on the slide because I got somebody, Anthony here, looks like he's sending me a message. So Anthony's got another box. I wouldn't consider it old. It's just a different variation called the Free TV Group box. Again, when it comes to boxes that have a small community, like the Free TV Group box or Jetstream. Jetstream was actually the very first box that I came to meet. It was very difficult to get any type of support from the manufacturer or the people running the boxes. So I ended up looking for that right team, and I believe I found it. I've been around the Xbox Kodi community for pretty much the beginning of stages. Like I mentioned earlier, I showed you my Xbox, and that box is part of the Kodi community. I mean, that whole Xbox, that's where it started before they changed their name. So they've been around for a good 15, 16 years now, right? And the community gets mad, I think, when all of these Android boxes pop out of the place and people are making money off of the concept. But you know, it's an opportunity for folks that see the vision to be able to make some income if they want to. I think that's good, but it's also smart to educate yourself as well. If you have a computer, a laptop, or a Macintosh, or a PC Windows based that has HDMI out, which means that you can output video from your computer to your TV, then this will serve you as well. You can have a box in that room. You know, it just doesn't look as pretty because it's a computer. I know they're making computers smaller now, so you may be able to find a little small version of a Windows computer and attach to that TV, or you can go about and do, you know, do something to the effect of building something to your liking. So I'm gonna, without further ado, I'm gonna show you the Windows version of this. What you see here before your eyes is by far one of my favorite skins that I've come across, and I find a few, but this is the most updated one I have that contains Kodi. It contains Exodus, and Exodus is kind of like the go-to place that replaced Genesis. And I shot a video here a few months back, maybe a year ago or so. It's been quite a while. Talking about a different skin that I liked, but that's been kind of not, it hasn't been updated. And so the reason I like this community build here is because it's been updated. So I'm going to show you how to access this. It's pretty quite simple. I'm going to start from the beginning. When you install Kodi, it's going to look pretty plain and simple. Something like this. Let me show you. So I'm going to change the skin. We're going to go to skin settings. And I'm going to change it to Confluence. Confluence is the original skin that your box or your install will open to. So let's see if it took me to the right place. It doesn't look like it. Let me go back. Let me click on System. Appearance. Skin. And we're going to change it from Eon Nox to something else. I don't even know if I pronounced that right, so forgive me if I did it. It's A-E-O-N. Aeon. I'll just go with Eon. Makes it easier for me. So here we go. You see how it right now it's highlighted over 5.8.6. Okay, this one's a little bit older. And then there's the original Confluence. Let's click on Confluence. I want to show you what this looks like before, and we'll keep the settings. And I'm gonna hit the home button down here at the bottom. So this is pretty much what it looks like. It looks pretty plain, right? And it actually has no add-ons added to it. And what I'm gonna show you tonight is how this is gonna be able to be put to what you saw right now. You're gonna head over to where it says System. We're gonna go down to where it says File Manager. We're gonna click on that. I've already added it, but you may need to do it, and it's a source called Movie Planet. So the way we do that is we go add source. I'll do it again so you guys can watch before your eyes. We're gonna hit enter on none. We're gonna type in this website. movieplanet.com.xa.com. So it's movie, it's http://movieplanet.com/xa.com. movieplanet.com/xa.com. And then you hit done. Then down here, you're going to type in Movie Planet. And just, you can just call it Movie Planet, but I'll call it Webinar since I already have one called Movie Planet. And hit OK. And then if you get a message saying, hey, this doesn't exist, most likely you typed it wrong. If that happens, then what you do is just go over to the location right there, and you press C on your keyboard, and you want to choose Edit Source. But because this is correct, I'm just going to hit OK. If you want to double-click on that, you'll notice that now you can see a menu, and that's because you're visiting that path on the internet. So let's go ahead and hit Home, the Home button down here at the bottom, big icon. And then we're going to click on System. We're going to click on Add-ons. We're going to click on Install from Zip File. Go down to Movie Planet, Webinar. We're going to go to Builds. And then you're going to run this from here. It says plugin.video.movieplanet. You're going to hit OK. I'm not going to do it since I've already done it, but just go ahead and do that and press OK. You'll see it download and install. Once you're done, you're gonna go, once it's done installing, you'll see a message pop up in your skin here saying Movie Planet has been added. So you're ready now to launch and install. You're essentially adding this little cloud hard drive in space to your build. Hit the home button, click on Programs, and then you're gonna click on where it says Movie Planet, right there. Click on that, hit OK, and you're gonna let it install, and you're done. It's gonna ask you to close the window, so you're gonna close the whole Kodi window by pressing OK on that screen once it's done installing. And then you're gonna be presented with, you would have to reopen Kodi again, and you'll be presented with that new skin that I just showed you. So let's go back to that skin again. And we're going to choose yes. And then there's no little house on this one. So what I usually do, there's no home button. What I usually do is use the backspace on my keyboard or the return on your mouse. If you're on Android, just use the back, the return, and it's going to take you back to the menu. Do it one more time. And that, now you're back at the main menu. So why do I like this one so much? Well, if you notice, if I go to movies, it's got the skin that rotates. On top of that, you got these little movies that pop up. There's the Jungle Book, there's Deadpool, and it gives me an awesome description by just putting my mouse over that movie. Doesn't that look really good? I think this looks awesome. So there you have it, easy access. And when you click on any of these, let's go ahead and click on the Jungle Book. You're automatically taken to the Exodus skin right there at the top. So So that's pretty cool. I think that's awesome. So let's go back and head back over here. I'm gonna head back to I'm gonna use my backspace on my keyboard. Go back to the menu. So that's my movies. Favorites down at the bottom. These are all shortcuts. Year, most views. Okay, that's for movies. So let's go over down to TV shows. Shows. You should be presented with an updated. So what's going on with TV shows? We got The Preacher, Penny Dreadful, Scream, Silicon Valley, Last Ship, Top Gear, Rain, Turn, Beep, Unreal. Perfect, right? So there you go. So I think this is pretty awesome. And if you want more, then obviously go into the skins there. So new releases, click on that, and it should take you over to all videos. Most likely, these are linked to, so there it is, linked to Exodus. So there's all your other options that you can see. So back out of here. The next tab over is kids. So let me click on, it's using a lot of memory now because I'm recording. So it's still thinking. Let me let it kick in for a second. Hopefully it recovers. All right, it's taking a while. I'm not sure what it's doing now. May have to close it because I was messing with the settings too hard. I don't know. Let me just kill it. So I'm going to kill it. No big deal. So if you guys are interested in, in this concept, Kodi is pretty sweet. Again, what I like about the internet through the Windows version is because Kodi allows you to do the updates on the spot. And if you do an update from Kodi, from like let's say a big build from 16 to 17, consider that this skin may not work on the version that's not Jarvis. For some reason, they make tweaks between versions that won't allow you to use that skin again on a different version. So keep that in mind. I've come across where there's an older build and it doesn't work on the older builds because of that. So it just recovered. So let me bring that over. There you go. Okay. I want to talk about the submenus in this here. Eon Nox allows you to change the bottom here. So let's just say, for example, TV shows, right? And I want my live TV down here at the bottom, most popular. So let's cruise over. Of course, there's kids tabs, there's IMDb, there's a sports tab. Actually, live TV should be here. So right now, I only have one option, which is C-Cloud, which some work and some don't. It's kind of hit or miss of channels here. But I'm going to add my other tab in there. So let's go ahead and go over to System. Then we can go to Appearance. And then we're going to go to Settings. And then we're going to set up the Eon Nox main menu, and I'm going to go to Live TV tab on the left-hand side, and then I want to select Manage the submenu. So technically right now we should only have one. Sure enough, it's called C-Cloud. So I'm going to add another one. It's going to show none. And this one's going to contain an add-on. So let's go down to the bottom. I think there's one called I want to say I'm going to find it under videos. Nope, that's not it. So I'll add it again. Change action, restore menu items, type maybe. There it is, type. Update library, update video library, clean type, no. That's not it. Add, move up, set labels, change action, maybe change action. There we go. Change action. So that's what you want to choose. And then we're going to choose the add-on. It's a video add-on called Channel Up TV. And it's getting your directory listing. I want to go ahead and just create the menu item here. Boom. It should update that to be Channel Up TV. Let me make sure I rename that, set label. Let me set the label to Channel Up TV. Perfect. So if everything worked, it should have changed the action to be that. So let's back out. Back out. So I'm using the backspace to back out of here. I'm going to head back over to my live TV area. And there's my channel up down here at the bottom. Oh. There's my channel up. And click on that guy. There you go. Let's see if we can get some live TV here. That's crazy.
Stretching is so important, class. Okay, let's just change positions. Oh boy.
What the?
Stuck in this band. Let me just gonna walk it out here. Yeah.
Okay, I've seen enough. I'm officially scared. Okay, so there it is. I just added my channel up. Okay, there's a whole process for that. So if you purchase this channel up over at jstvbox.com, you can add an account. You can't share accounts between boxes because it will kick one of the accounts out. Trust me, I've already tried it. So there you have it. There's a lot of different add-ons here that aren't present in the front menu. If you want to add one of these, let's say, for example, Phoenix. I think someone asked earlier this week, how can I add documentaries? I lost the documentaries area. Oh, perfect. I found one under Phoenix. So let's go and add that to live TV. So I'm going to go to system. See, there's a shortcut. Here we go. System skin settings down at the bottom. Bam. And then I'm going to go set up the AI menu. Then I'm going to go to live TV. And then manage sub menu. And let's go ahead and add another one, and then we can change this one. I want to move that one down to be the last one. Let's make Channel TV the first one, so let's move that up. Up, there it is. So that last one would be none. We're going to change the action, and I want to choose a video add-on called Phoenix. So click on Video Library. It's a video add-on. Makes it confusing because there's actually video add-on and video add-on. So let's choose video add-on and see if that shows up. Okay, that didn't work the way I wanted to. Go down to where it says add-on, and then video add-on. There you go. That's where you want to do it. So you should be under this menu called video add-ons. Let's go down to Phoenix. Bam, Phoenix. It's going to give us a menu. I know I found it under 124.24.15. And documentaries are somewhere in here. I mean, I just passed it. There's classic TV series, so there's another one you can add on. There's a gang of stuff in here. There it is, documentaries. And you can add sports documentaries under the sports section. So you can really customize this the way you want it and make it look really nice. I'll create the menu from here. Perfect. And then I'm going to give it a different name. So I'm going to set the label to documentaries. I hope I spelled that right. If not, don't shoot me. All right, backspace, 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 backspace. And it's creating the menu for you. It usually takes a few seconds to update. And go over to live TV. Bam, there's your documentaries. Cloud. I'm building my sub menus here. So if you don't like one of the menus, you can always modify them. Under add-ons, there is a shortcut to HD movies, 123 movies, Phoenix, Disney, Dizbox, Cloud, Exodus. That's under add-ons. So kids, same thing, animation, family, kids shows. And if I'm not mistaken, this is an adult clean system for the most part. I don't think there's any adult add-ons. But for any reason you're offended by the adult add-on, you can turn those off under the videos add-on section. Yeah, I don't have that on mine because I got kids, so don't need that here in the household. But if you guys want to add those or remove them, that's all done from the add-on section. Okay, I think I've covered quite a bit here. So coming towards the end of the week, most likely on Friday, maybe Thursday, I will be talking about a box here that is the latest in 2016. For those that have purchased a Channel Up TV box for me, and you want a second box, and you want dibs on this, you know, private message me. I will get you a complimentary discount price on that second box. If you want to become a wholesaler and buy in bulk and move these things like a real-time way, I mean, you want to make a six-figure and beyond income, this is the way to do it. You want to buy in bulk and get a cheaper price, I can get you a better discount, and then you can sell these boxes either at the swap meet. I see a lot of folks selling these at the swap meets, or you can sell them, you know, within friends, which in my opinion is the best way to go. And you can save some money. You can save quite a bit of money from not having to pay for traditional TV that typically, you know, like I have 1 year free of Netflix. It's the only reason I have it, because it came with my phone. But, you know, typically Netflix doesn't have the TV shows I want to watch or movie shows I want to watch because they're so outdated or they're behind a whole season. What I like about Kodi is, as you know, to use Kodi for a while now, you can watch updated shows and updated movies as well. So if there are any questions about that, you guys are welcome to ask me. Just send me a private message on Facebook, and I'll be happy to answer those questions. But this webinar is recorded for you guys. You can go back and review on how to install the skin. Again, a very good-looking skin. And as long as you have Jarvis, this should work with a Jarvis build, whether you're on Android or whether you're on a Windows or Mac PC. If you've already installed Jarvis before and you have a different skin, I can't guarantee you the skin's going to work fresh because it's not a fresh install, so I can't guarantee it's going to be popping up. Because I've had it happen where I've had a Jarvis build and I was using a different skin and it kind of broke trying to install this one. So again, any questions, feel free to ask them in the room. I am here to assist you guys. I am a very, very busy person. I run a few different businesses, but this is always kind of fun to help folks save some money. And then in the future, we can talk about how to invest that money that you're spending
I don't know, an additional $1,000 plus a year on entertainment, put it towards something of greater value that help you generate some income. I'm all about that, and I'm sure you are too if you're a smart person. Actually, you don't have to be the sharpest tool in the shed to figure out that putting more money back in your pocket, you can do some things like bless other people or go do some missionary work or whatever. Whatever you do with your free time, everybody handles their time differently. But I know that saving money is a pretty big deal right now, especially in this economy for a lot of folks. And I know these boxers are getting more and more popular, so there's no better time than to take action and get involved if you choose to make this a little side business as soon as yesterday, because more and more folks are starting to get wind of these. But the question is always, you know, how does these boxes or these Android boxes compare to like an Android Kodi TV? And I answered that question earlier, but just to recap, you're not going to get the full spectrum of premium add-ons that I like. For example, Channel Up is not going to be included with that install. You know, when you get something hacked and jailbroken for $100 or less, you're not going to get the premium add-ons. You typically only get partial. But you see here a lot of the free stuff, which some people may be content with that. But if you want the premium add-ons, you kind of have to pay the price. And that's what I've learned for sure. So if there's any questions, again, feel free to ask them into the room. If not, you guys have yourselves a great day. We'll talk to you on the next one. Bye now.